shall we start? Somebody outside? Are there anybody outside? So a very good morning. Can you hear me? Is the mic on? Can you hear me? A very good morning. So this program is being streamed all over the country. Okay.
Oh yeah. Oh. Thanks. We hope that people are switching on their laptops or computers and or mobiles and watching it. Could you just start that? We also have centers, you must be knowing, we also have centers in US and Britain. So I think we will start with a movie or a sort of visual which will set, the earlier one. Set the winter ambience. This one, yeah. Can you see that there? Not the winter of India, yeah, winter of Boston. Can we remove this side? This event. Music. And please pay attention to the music. If you can hear. Can you? No. Can you just?
No, it is not connected.
Where is it coming?
I think it's not connected. Okay, I hope some of you must be knowing about this music. This is a very famous music called by Vivaldi, called Four Seasons. So he has winter, summer, autumn, all seasons, spring, winter, spring, summer, autumn. So out of which this winter is the one that, so this photo and the visuals have come from Acton, Massachusetts, one of our centers there. One of the students from there was working here during summer. Some of you must be knowing about her, Anandita Lal. So she has been sending, as you people have been sending, and people from around the country has been sending visuals on seasons, she has sent it. So we thought that we will just start with that. So this session is actually the culmination of the winter workshop, is it not? So we had a winter workshop, we had winter extended workshop, and so this is a culmination of that. And two very important things that is going to happen here, according to me, is people who have worked from summer onwards, that is 2017 summer onwards, including Diwali, Ganesh Chaturthi vacation, Diwali vacation, Christmas vacation, till the whatever has been done till then, till now, is being presented here by the groups of people. Yeah. So Jay probably will know, they know, will know who are the which are the groups. I just wanted to announce only two things. That one, that this all has been happening through cube, through groups. Yeah, the collaborative groups. The second is that there has been a lot of initiatives coming from a large number of people who are starting locality labs in different parts of the country through very popular projects like the mango mapping, yeah, and the butterfly mapping, etc., etc. So these are the major events that probably we will be highlighting also, while people will be discussing about the initiation of new programs, new research programs. I'm sure that people are ready with that. And I would like to also say something about the awards that we often give in such assembly. So there are three group types of awards that this time we are going to announce, and the announcement will come afterwards. So one is the DD Kosambi Award for cultivation of scientific timber and remodeling the curriculum at the delivery stage, cultivating scientific timber, and also to remodel the curriculum at the delivery stage, in the sense in the classroom that cultivation of scientific timber will take place. The second is SK Mahajan Award for science education and research initiatives, which some among you will must be deserving it. So that also will be announced. And the third one is Anil Sadgopal People Science Awards for popularization of science, which many institutions, many groups, cube groups have been doing that. So with that, I will be starting this, and I will ask Nagarjuna to come and make a few comments.
See, Aruna knows very well that I have no more comments to make. So that's why he called me. But, you know, this time we were not able to get other cubists from other places. Otherwise, this conference, you know, we get people from Mumbai, Delhi, Goa, Kochi, Jaipur, Lucknow, and you know, and Assam, various other places. But so this time, due to a lot of logistic reasons, we were not able to do that. But we're trying to compensate that by making sure that this proceedings are streamed live. And I think most of you may already know the link, because that has been broadcasted already. So please send it to your friends from various other places to make sure that they participate. And as you already know, that there is also discussion that could happen in our own channels also, but you can also discuss while you are doing live stream. Suppose if any of your friends have questions, they could possibly ask them through the YouTube streaming session itself, so that we can pick up some of those questions and even answer them here. Well, I mean, this time I would actually request all of you for while you make presentations, because almost all of you are going to make presentations today. And so when you make these presentations, I would request you to keep sufficient time for question answers as well, so that you know, the whole point is to have some good discussion, and then we could continue to follow it up. You don't have to tell only the results that you got. As you know, we also talk about not getting results as well. Okay, and that is in fact the reason why the other people could actually come and help us. Why are we not getting the results that we wanted? Or maybe they know the answers and things like that. So it is through this kind of collaboration that we are celebrating this. But before I say, let me briefly tell you some important things that are happening to the CUBE program itself as a project. First of all, there is a lot of demand for this kind of programs at various other places. And the institute, the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, has been reviewed by University Grants Commission. So a group of experts have visited all the centers of TIFR. So which means what? Maybe some of you may not know that there is one big campus in Colaba. There is another big campus coming up in Hyderabad. Apart from that, we have 4 more centers. Okay, one for theoretical physics in Bangalore, and NCBS already, many of you may know, the Center for Biological Molecular Biology at Bangalore. And then we also have Radio Astronomy Center in Pune. And Homi Bhabha Center is the 4th such centers. Of course, in terms of history, the last one was the center that set up was the Center for Theoretical Physics, Theoretical Sciences, also in Bangalore. So now, all these centers are also visited by the experts. And while they are giving the report, they also have to mention, like, what are the innovations that they have seen in all these places. So you will be happy to know that CUBE is one of them. So they made a special mention. Of course, TIFR gets A+ grade accreditation, so there is no doubt about that. But then making sure that they have actually cognized that there is some innovation happening in education, and they have identified CUBE project. And so that's a huge recognition for us. And this is the 5th, 5.5? Yeah, is it 5.5 or just 5.5 year? I think we started in 2012 May. And so we are sort of running great. And now we have approximately 2,000 members combining all the groups that we have. We have the mailing list, we got WhatsApp groups and social network. Of course, a large number of people are overlapping because the same people who are on Facebook are also there on WhatsApp, and the same people who are on WhatsApp also there on the mailing list and things like that. And then, so this has been one of the means of increasing the outreach. And then we also have this year, particularly keeping in mind this particular event, we started a Telegram group also. Some of you may be wondering why Telegram, why not WhatsApp and things like that. So one of the most important reason, of course, is that firstly, Telegram is a free software. The second important reason is that Telegram allows you to have any number in the group, a large number in the group. You know, WhatsApp may have restrictions in that. Whereas here, for example, you can almost go up to, you know, 100,000 members within a single group. And therefore, there is a possibility for you to have a lot of possibility. And if the group is a broadcast group, you can actually go for several millions as well. So in that sense, we have this possibility. And the second thing that we are working on, in fact, some of my software colleagues who are working in Homi Bhabha Center are developing a direct link from Telegram to a MetaStudio website. So that, you know, when you are discussing, the discussions are also automatically published on the website. And when you upload a picture, the picture is automatically uploaded on the main website. So these changes are going to actually make our web presence even more interesting. And when the number actually increases to a large extent. And just now, Arunan mentioned that we have a small group in Boston. You know, it could be one person, but the point is that when that person is making some things there, other people will be asking, what are you doing? And then in the process, you know, people get to know about it. About 3 months ago, we had a big gang of international visitors who visited our CUBE lab from IBM. So when those guys came, they were so impressed. And one of the IBM scientists went back to US, and she's from Georgia, and her daughter is studying in a particular school there. And she wrote to the principal of that school saying that this is the kind of program that American kids need. And so she highly recommended the principal to get in touch with us and initiate this program. In fact, we're already in the process of preparing an online program for them, starting from Mumbai. So Mumbai will be connecting to a school in Georgia in the United States. So that means basically that, you know, slowly your message is reaching out, not only within the country, but also going out, because it's a very unique program. And as most of you know, this unique program is unique in what ways? So it is an important moment for us to actually understand what those uniquenesses are. Of course, everybody knows that collaboration is one of the uniqueness, because competition is the uniqueness of regular classroom, whereas here we celebrate collaboration. Copying is allowed in this program, because copying is our birthright, and that's the reason why we are human beings. Otherwise, we don't learn anything from anyone, not from fathers, not from mothers, not from anybody. So we are actually being trained to copy to begin with, and then when you go to school, you say that, you know, you're not supposed to copy. Well, we are very proud to say that copying is a virtue, not a vice. All right. So therefore, our examinations will be of a different kind, naturally. As you can see, we also sometimes recognize some individual talent for their commitment, for their devoted way in which they actually participate in the CUBE activity. So we are recognizing the people as well. And those people, actually, even before we recognize, all of you would recognize them as well, because you know who are the people who are active. What does it mean? That means transparency. So transparency is another important character of our program. And not only that, we also have certain other interesting characters of that. We are focusing on culture and not content. Of course, content is already there. I mean, everybody knows about you know, DNA, molecular biology, stone chemistry, you know, all kinds of jargon that we use in a regular biology class. We also do that. But then we have a context to do that. And that means basically that, you know, we are having a very deep-rooted experimental context in the lab. And then it is in that context that now we start talking about these subjects. And as a result, what happens, the understanding that we gather from all these activities becomes part of our life. And what good it is if science doesn't become part of our life? Why should it be confined to the classrooms? Why should it be confined to just passing some exam or something like that? And in fact, that is one of the reasons why ignorant ministers, you know, say that Darwin should be removed from the curriculum. It's almost like saying that biology should be removed from the curriculum, because I really do not see any reason why the Darwin should be removed from the curriculum. I don't know how many of you are aware of the history. In fact, yesterday Meena mentioned this while she was reading one of the great biologists Ernst Mayr's book, where he also mentioned this point, that physics was the one of the most and most successful branches of science which started. But you know what? The physics could not challenge the religious beliefs, except to some extent because of the reason that, you know, the earth is not the center of the world, but the sun is, or maybe later on, you know, there is nothing like a center in the universe. So that physics has demonstrated. But even though people are happy with that, they said, well, that's about inanimate things. But the animate things are very important, and therefore that is where, you know, religion would continue to play a very important role. But then that one actually has been devastated strongly by Darwin, particularly after his fascinating observations by collecting a lot of information from across the country. And this is where an important lesson that we have to learn from Darwin. Let me take 1 minute, because that is another culture that we are also propagating about. You know what? Do you have any idea how many letters Darwin wrote professionally to people in those days? In those days means what? Where even a pigeon was used for delivery of letters. Of course, postmen were there, but to manage the last mile delivery, they were actually using pigeons in those days. We are talking about those days. And can you tell me how many letters he wrote? Anybody? 100? 100 letters won't make anybody a scientist. 1,000 also won't make anybody a scientist. Yeah, it is around, I mean, my memory may be wrong, but I remember it as 17,000. Okay, 17,000 letters in those days, written by one scientist, who is not recognized most of his during his lifetime, but has been continuously, incessantly writing about all those observations and then talking to people, talking to scholars, talking to scientists across Europe, not just in his own place. So what are those letters consisting of? Letters consist of observations that he has made and then his opinion of how to interpret those observations. And now we make a lot of observations. We make a lot of observations in our own classroom, in our lab, and also outside. And we are now doing this mango mapping project, like tree mapping and things like that. You know, each of these observations might appear to be very trivial to you. I mean, what is the big deal of doing science, just taking a picture of a mango tree and then sharing it with everybody? But the point is that that kind of data is what makes science possible. You have to understand the relevance of sharing observations with a large group of people. And Darwin took meticulous notes of almost every day, everything that he saw. And he also made one more thing. He also used to draw almost everything that he used to see. So drawing is also an important part of this thing. So what are all these things? These are all part of culture. You know, sharing immediately to your colleagues, discussing them, engaging them, writing letters. Now today we are writing emails and you know, instant messages and things like that, and discussing them, collating that information, and then wondering about how to explain each of those phenomena that you are observing. So all this is part of the culture of doing science and trying to explain them. And you don't have to be correct when you are trying to explain, but the point is you have an aptitude or interest to explain is what matters. So it is in that sense, friends, most importantly, the cubists are actually demonstrating the point that it is not just those people who excel with you know, very good marks and then, you know, keep passing all the exams and, you know, go out and pass out all these competitive exams and things like that is not going to lead to creating a scientific culture in the country or anywhere in the world. The true scientific literacy is only when science is done. Science is not read. Okay, so you can't just read science. You have to do science, and you have to do it in the lab. You have to do it outside in the world. And because it's biology, we have a great future. And the most important peculiar aspect of the cube, which identifies itself, is in the aspect of simple model organisms. And I must mention that we have actually succeeded in introducing a new model organism this year. And this new model organism is Hydra. Okay, but not in the way how other researchers ask us to maintain Hydra. Because the scientists ask us to maintain Hydra, which is a freshwater organism, and then you ask us to feed a marine crustacean. Right, which is a problem there. So our cubists have successfully cultured Hydra using a freshwater Daphnia or Moina, whatever you want to call it. And now experiments are still going on whether Hydra could even survive using and feeding on rotifers. And that experiment is still on. We still not know. But at least we are quite certain today that we have successfully managed to maintain Hydra just using Moina, which essentially means that Moina can be maintained within that kind of species. And the other thing has been also being tried out is how to maintain Hydra in hydrilla culture. So hydrilla is an aquatic plant. So in the combination of a hydrilla aquatic plant and the chlorohydra, which is also photosynthetic, that combination is also being tested. So which means that it is possible to keep a Hydra cup or a bottle on top of your reading table and continue to maintain it. So that is what we are doing. You know, the cube, almost all the model organisms that we are working with cube can actually be maintained on top of your reading table. It's a tabletop lab is what we are creating. And that is very important. And that is only when okay, science will be done in every street. People keep asking, you know, that why is it that, you know, we don't have any Nobel Prize winners in India? We have very few. All of you know that. And very few in science. Now, what could be the reason? But what about cricketers? We are the best cricketing team in the world. Isn't it? Do you all agree? Do you know the reason why? What is the reason? It happens on every street. It happens on every street. And they don't care whether they actually have a cricket bat. They take anything that looks like fatta and start playing.
Here is a statement.
Yes. Absolutely, cricket is a culture in India. Cricket is a culture in India. Science has not become a culture in India, and that is what CUBE is trying to demonstrate. So CUBE is trying to innovate on the possibilities of how to take science to every street, and not only every street, onto every reading table. Of course, every child doesn't have a reading table. It could be a mat on the floor. How does it matter? In fact, we have people coming from the MWARD center, and in the MWARD center there are no tables, and we are actually sitting on the floor and doing experiments there. Okay, and so this is also, of course, another interesting thing that actually happened, that we have now started working with communities at MWARD project. So this is another new thing that has happened. I'm happy Tuba also has come here. So she coordinates the center of the MWARD project on behalf of TISS. So as a result, you know, what is happening is our network is not only expanding, but it is also getting recognized. And so with these few words of trying to tell exactly what is this main important difference that the CUBE is trying to make, and all of you are the champions of that thing. You know, people will remember after several years that, you know, India is transformed because of the CUBEists. So you are the champions who are actually making that happen. Okay, so thank you so much for listening. And now, of course, we're going to start the presentations. Now, who is going to chair, Meena or Jay? Jay is going to conduct the session, one after the other. And please maintain the time. Though I have violated the point, I took a long time telling about it. But that will help the last timers also to have the same amount of time that you get. Okay.
Okay, so after the inspirational speech by Arunan sir and Jain sir, so we'll begin the session. So basically, I would like to begin the session with by just showing one movie, which is made by a cubist who is, you know, working in Delhi. So I will just so can you light off? Yeah, it is 10, 20 minutes. 20 minutes, yeah. Oh, sorry. So we have a movie which is there. So I'll be just showing the movie. Okay, this the name of the student is Kajal. So she has made this movie. She is actually working in a center which is called, they call it as a think lab. So they have created small center which is, and they are working there. So I'll just paste.
Yeah, it is there. Yeah, it is working. Okay.
Yeah, it will begin.
Sound here? Volume level?
Amazing, isn't she? But honestly, it was not love at first sight. I haven't heard about Daphnia already a lot of times of my being in Cube for almost an year now. But it was only in that winter workshop at the end of 2015 in Mumbai that I actually met TCDS in person. She was beautiful, just like this. And a scholar as well with epigenetic studies. So at first I thought she was way out of my league, but her simplicity made it all easier. She could mix with anyone. I mean, unlike other model systems, she could take care of herself very easily if given attention only once a day with a drop of milk. It was the beginning though. As the days passed, I got to see her different colors, from transparent to pale to red, and I started to get along with her more. We brought her together at Delhi to get to know more about her. But as they say, and I experienced, things don't always turn out the way we imagine it to be. Within a month, I was struggling to keep things as planned. Our cultures were not working. We were not able to figure out what was wrong. She used to be such a lively creature, and now
I think there is some issue with the internet connectivity, so
what was wrong? She used to be such a lively creature, and now
okay.
We started to try finding answers and made our hypothesis, and we came up with temperature. Made sense back then, not now though. Rejected. Next, the water. To be honest, it's embarrassing to even mention it now. Well, whatever the reason was, it definitely was not me, right? Wrong, as I came to realize eventually. She did not only teach me the scientific method. So the perks of working in a group where there is mutual benefit.
So the perks of working in a group where there is mutual benefit to everyone.
Yeah, collaboration. So I decided it was my time to pay her back, and by chance I got the chance. I had not expected that it will be this difficult to convince others. Evidences they need. So I guess it was time to learn more things. and as always, collaborators came to the rescue. Because evidences were important, so was the approval. After all, she deserved to be known for what she was. Soon enough, she got to be known as Moina now. But I still had to know few more things.
We will be watching it after some time because there's a lot of problem in the internet.
Not defined by instruments and devices, but model systems. That inspiration does not always look like him or her or him. And the same goes for collaboration. It looked like this once. But the most important thing that I had to learn still awaited. Apparently, the Moina claim needed more attention. So, I continued. The labs changed. She stayed. The faces changed, but she was there. The question changed, and she was still there. However, apparently, these questions escalated quite quickly. Huh? She indeed is interesting. Now, whenever I look back, I end up recalling the first lesson I ever learned in Cube. That the most important thing is the culture, and evidently it is, be it the culture of your model system or the culture of the cube itself, the three C's, communication, collaboration and continuity. So stay curious and keep questioning, because as they say,
the answer my friend is blowing in the wind, the answer is
okay, so basically she was talking about her journey of Moina. She's a student from Delhi. She has been working on Moina for a long period of time. She has also come here quite some time. So she carried things from here and there. So she said that the lab keeps changing, but the organism was still alive, and they were able to maintain it. The difficulties which they faced in maintenance, and how they were trying to identify what it is. You know, and then they went and collaborated with people who are actually experts in that area, and then they came to know that it is Moina and so on. So the Moina which we just introduced is also now in the lab. What currently is happening in Cube Lab is that we are actually feeding this Moina to some other organism which is Hydra. So basically, I will like to call the Hydra group now to present and talk about the work which they are doing on maintenance of the Hydra. Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Okay, good morning, Cubists. Good to see everybody here. So as we are starting with Hydra as a model system, I would just like to briefly mention the journey of Hydra in Cube Lab. till now, and what are the challenges and what are the future directions. So we got Hydra from the Agarkar Research Institute lab. People were, when we had some visitors, they say ki kahan pe milta hai, talab mein milta hai kya, agar hum jayenge to humko bhi mil jayega kya, wagera. So they keep on asking. So we got, of course, in Agarkar Research Institute, Professor Surendra, he got a single Hydra, it seems, from a lake near some North Indian part of the country, and then they could culture the Hydra into thousands and thousands of many such polyps. Anyway, so we got the Hydra from the ARLI lab, which is a very sophisticated research based lab, and with the objective of spreading it to the country, right, and the colleges. So what do we do? Because it's a research lab, they follow various protocols. So Hydra is a freshwater organism, and they are feeding the Artemia, which is a saltwater tiny crustacean. So the routine is you first hatch the eggs. The Artemia is a crustacean. It is procured as a dried cyst, small eggs. So you put it in a salt water, aerate it, and then wait for it. This is the setup for the Artemia hatch. You can see here, you may have seen it many times in the cube lab. So you can see it here. This is a tiny setup. In the beaker, there is some water, dechlorinated water, and some salt is added because it's a saltwater crustacean, and then we add some cysts. And then there is an aeration pump, which is normally seen in the fish tank, wagera, aquarium. So we keep it for aeration for a day or so, or 1.5 days or two days. And then we have to wait if the eggs, Artemia is laying, hatched or not. And then on second day or on third day, we wash the Artemia. Sort of, washing is also another procedure added to it. And then we feed the Hydra. Sometimes you can see here, it's a big lamp that is introduced. During our winters, we used to not get the Artemia hatch in, say, the prescribed 18 hours or so. So we thought it could be because of the temperature. So we introduced, by reading literature, we introduced a lamp so that there is a little bit of higher temperature is maintained. So, and then we used to get Artemia hatch after, say, after at least 24 hours ke baad, we used to get it. So this was quite a tedious process. And then procuring dried cysts is also a economically not so good thing to be sharing. So we thought, can we substitute it with the already existing things that are already there in the cube lab? So can one model organism be useful for another model organism, right? So sharing, collaboration, can it also work with the model organisms? So there was such question. And of course, then there were other challenges, and then we made some goof ups. We kept Hydra in the broad sunlight, and then everything got disintegrated. So that way, then several goof ups happened. Then we started feeding it with Moina. Now we all know Moina is a freshwater organism. It doesn't require so much of hassle. First of all, we have plenty of Moina in our labs. Everybody can sort of culture it and maintain it in their homes or labs or college kitchen or tabletop or just in a bottle or in a test tube. So one easily available organism can be substituted with this very hassle thing like Artemia and all. So can it be tried? So that was one project that Arif and others, his colleagues or his friends did, and then they succeeded. So Arif will tell that journey. And iske aage jaake, we wanted to also start. He's prompting me that we wanted to create an ecosystem, self-sustaining ecosystem. So ek ecosystem mein kya ho sakta hai? Plants, algae, and some organisms, right? Sort of living or culturing happily. Then what was introduced, like aquatic plant like hydrilla or some other algae, need to be introduced. And then us algae mein, can Moina survive? And then agar Moina survive hota hai toh, can Hydra survive? So ye sustainable ecosystem kaise ban sakta hai, uska ek project tha. Then these VES college people joined Arif, and then I think they are going to tell this their fantastic journey in this presentation. Anything to be added? SIS, okay, yeah. Carry on.
Good morning, one and all present over here. Myself, Dipti, from VS College. She is Harshada, and herself is Ashwini. We are all from VS College, and Arif is our mentor. Today we are going to present about Hydra, which is our model organism. Basically, Hydra is a small freshwater organism of phylum Cnidaria. They are native to temperate and tropical regions. Hydra is tubular, radially symmetrical, and about 10 millimeter long. It has 7 to 8 tentacles, which helps us to catch the food, head part, middle part, and the basal part for the attachment to the surface. Hydra normally feeds on Moina and Artemia. Hydra are biologically immortal as they have regenerating capacity. Further part will be explained by Arif.
तो यहाँ पे या हाइड्रा टू मोइना इसलिए क्योंकि मैं पहले मोइना पे काम कर रहा था तो यहाँ पे मतलब लैब से फिर आर्टिमिया मीना मैम जिसने बताया कि आर्टिमिया फीडिंग कर रहे तो पे हाई मतलब मोइना टू हाइड्रा ये मेरा है तो यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं ये आर्टिमिया कैसे है ये आर्टिमिया है ये आर्टिमिया और ये मोइना है मतलब आर्टिमिया भी मोइना की तरह से सेम दिखता है पर ये आर्टिमिया सॉल्ट वाटर ऑर्गेनिज्म है और मोइना फ्रेश वाटर ऑर्गेनिज्म जो हाइड्रा हम लोग का फ्रेश वाटर ऑर्गेनिज्म है और मोइना भी फ्रेश वाटर ऑर्गेनिज्म है तो हम लोग मोइना हाइड्रा को इजीली फीड कर सकते हैं और आर्टिमिया सॉल्ट वाटर है जैसे कि मीना में इकोनॉमिक्स में एक्सपेंसिव है वो अगर उसका हम लोग आधा जो 15 केजी का अगर हम लोग 1.5 केजी का डब्बा अगर हम लोग खरीदें तो कहते हैं 900 तक वो आता है इतना एक्सपेंसिव है जैसे कि अगर कोई अगर लैब में अगर जैसे कि कॉलेज में किसी को करना है तो वो ख़रीदना पड़ेगा फिर उसके आके उसके बाद हम लोग को हाइड्रा कल्चर करना पड़ेगा तो इतना सारा मतलब ख़रीदने के बाद फिर उसको करें फिर हाइड्रा मर गया तो फिर पूरा टोटल वेस्ट हो जाता है उसके लिए मैंने यहाँ पे काट रहा है मोइना सो आई मोइना टू हाइड्रा तुम्हें यही मतलब कि इसको जितना ईजी करना है आर्टिमिया हम लोग उसको फीड नहीं कर रहे हैं आर्टिमिया बहुत डिफिकल्टी फीडिंग करना तो मीना मैम वो प्रोसेस कर रहे थे तो मैं उसको ईजी करने के लिए मोइना लिया फिर यहाँ पे जो मीना मैम यहाँ पे लैम्प से कल्चर लैम्प और हाइड्रा सेटअप जो आप मीना मैम ने इंट्रोड्यूस किया एयर पम्प बीकर सॉल्ट वाटर सिस्ट ये सब रिक्वायरमेंट्स है हाइड्रा को कल्चर करने के लिए और यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं ये हाइड्रा आर्टिमिया खा रहे हैं ये सब आर्टिमिया और ये हाइड्रा है सो आर्टिमिया कल्चर जैसे मीना मैम ने एक्सप्लेन कर चुका है ऑलरेडी और ये मोइना सेटअप के लिए कुछ ज़्यादा हमने रिक्वायरमेंट्स की नहीं है उसके लिए हम लोग को बॉटल्स चाहिए तो बॉटल्स यहाँ पे है जैसे वन ड्रॉप का ये दोनों बॉटल वन ड्रॉप मिल्क का है और ये यहाँ पे मोइना हाइड्रा मोइना खा रहे हैं तो मोइना कल्चर अगर किसी को अगर लैब में करना है तो कोई कैसे कर सकता है उसके लिए रिक्वायरमेंट दो ट्रांसपेरेंट बोतल और डीक्लोरिनेटेड वाटर डीक्लोरिनेटेड वाटर मीन्स इसमें क्लोरीन ना हो जैसे बीएमसी जो हम लोग को वाटर प्रोवाइड करती है उसमें क्लोरीन होता है बीएमसी इसमें क्लोरीन डालती है इसके माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स को मारने के लिए तो हम लोग को ये क्लोरीन निकालना है तो फिर ये क्लोरीन निकालने के बाद हम लोग को तो क्लोरीन हम लोग निकालेंगे कैसे उसके लिए यहाँ पे देखा यहाँ पे बॉटल्स का रिक्वायरमेंट और ये डीसी वाटर है तो यहाँ टैप वाटर जो हम लोग ने यहाँ पे ये बकेट इसमें लिया है इसको हम लोग 24 आवर्स के लिए रखते हैं इसमें क्लोरीन गैस है तो निकल जाएगा ड्रॉपर मोइना मिल्क ये मोइना कल्चर करने के लिए अरे ये मोइना का ग्राफ है तो मतलब अगर मोइना हम लोग स्टार्टिंग में कल्चर करें तो हम लोग को कितने मोइनास मिल जाएंगे एक वीक में तो देखते हैं अगर मोइना हम लोग ने 5 से यहाँ पे स्टार्ट किया है तो 5 से हम लोग 5 डेज में अराउंड 50 मोइना हम लोग को मिल जाते हैं ये दोनों वन ड्रॉप बॉटल है तो अभी हम लोग को अगर एक्सपेरिमेंट करना है तो हम लोग को डुप्लीकेट्स बनाना होता है अगर फर्स्ट बोतल मोइना का अगर मर गया तो दूसरा बोतल जिंदा रहेगा तो उससे वो हम लोग यूज़ कर सकते हैं इसलिए अगर हम लोग एक्सपेरिमेंट कोई भी करें तो हम लोग डुप्लीकेट्स बनाना बहुत उसका इम्पोर्टेंट है यहाँ पे हाइड्रा को कैसे हम लोग फ्री दो हाइड्रा इसे बताया कि ये सब यहाँ पे कॉलेज में और घर पे भी एक्सपेरिमेंट है तो जैसे किचन लैब हम लोग बोल रहे हैं वो घर पे भी कर रहे हैं तो फिर आइस ट्रे है आइस क्यूब ट्रे तो इसमें आइस स्ट्रिप ट्रे में हाइड्रा कल्चर कर रहे हैं, इसमें 1-1 हाइड्रा लिया है। और फिर उसके लिए रिक्वायरमेंट्स, जैसे कि हाइड्रा जैसे आरटी में अगर फीड करें तो उसमें भी क्लीनिंग करने की ज़रूरत होती है, तो वो सब रिक्वायरमेंट्स, ग्लास, मोइना, ये मोइना का कप है, तो हम लोग अगर बोटल सीखे, अगर बोटल्स ना मिले तो कोई बोलता है अगर किसको करना है एक्सपेरिमेंट, कोई बोले बोटल्स नहीं मिले तो एक्सपेरिमेंट कैसे स्टार्ट कर सकते, कप्स नहीं मिल रहे, तो सबसे सिंपल अगर बोटल्स तो जल्दी हम लोग ढूंढने बाहर जाना पड़ेगा, बोटल्स मिलेंगे नहीं, ये तो बिस्लेरी बोटल खरीदना पड़ेगा, पानी पियो, तो ईजिली हम लोग सबसे कप जो दुकान पे कोई भी दुकान पे जाएंगे तो हम लोग को मिल जाता। तो कप ये अराउंड जो ये कप दिख रहा है मोइना का, इसमें अराउंड 300 ml का, इसमें 250 ml DC वाटर है और इसमें 1 drop मिल्क डेली फीडिंग। और ये कुछ स्टेप्स हैं जो पहले हम लोग एक एम्प्टी ग्लास लेना, मोइना वॉशिंग करनी है, तो हम लोग इसको भी मतलब वॉश करके फीडिंग करते हैं, उसमें जो मिल्क का कंटेंट रहता है वो हम लोग को निकालना पड़ता है। उसके लिए फर्स्ट हम लोग को यहाँ पे मसलिन क्लॉथ ही है, तो मसलिन क्लॉथ ग्लास के ऊपर रखना है, फिर मोइना बॉटल्स या तो कप्स में है, तो इन सब लोग ने कप्स में कल्चर किया था, तो ये फिर यहाँ से निकाल के फिर यहाँ पे मोइना डाला है। फिर मोइना लेने के बाद फिर हम लोग को DC वाटर लेना है, ये इस बीकर में DC वाटर है, फिर DC वाटर जो उसको वॉश करना है, अगर टैप वाटर है तो टैप वाटर भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं। और फिर उसको एक पेट्री प्लेट या तो कोई अगर कैप है बड़ा सा, अगर घर पे जैसे कि हम लोग पेट्री प्लेट नहीं ले सकते तो घर पे हम लोग कैप्स कैप या तो कोई है जैसे खाने पीने की चीज़ तो उसमें रख के मोइना हम लोग ये कॉटन को लेके इसमें हम लोग को सब पल्टी करना रहेगा मोइना, उसमें इसमें पानी भी डाला DC वाटर, तो यहाँ पर मोइना हम लोग को ऐसे यहाँ पे देखे या तो डॉट डॉट थोड़ा ये मोइना है, तो फिर उसके बाद हम लोग को फीडिंग करना है। तो 10th स्टेप जो हम लोग को उसको फीडिंग करना है, तो फीडिंग करने के बाद मोइना यहाँ पे हाइड्रा मोइना खा रहे हैं। तो मैंने इसके ऊपर एक्सपेरिमेंट क्या किया, तो यहाँ पे दिख रहा है हाइड्रा कल्चर प्लस एल्गे मोइना, तो यहाँ पे इसलिए मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव था कि इको सिस्टम बनाने के लिए हाइड्रा का, तो फर्स्ट A1 B1 में 1 हाइड्रा है, और A2 B2 में 2 हाइड्रा, A1 A3 और B3 में 3 हाइड्रा। तो फर्स्ट टाइम इसमें मतलब बहुत सारे मतलब गुफअप्स मतलब मिस्टिक्स इसमें मैंने बहुत सारा किया, तो मतलब इसमें मैंने डेटा प्लॉटिंग करना भूल गया हूँ, तो मैंने वापस से गुफअप्स ने अभी किया है। तो इसमें कि फर्स्ट डे मैं स्टार्ट 17 January को किया था, तो इसमें फर्स्ट डे मैं जो ऊपर के A1 A2 जो ए सीरीज़ है उसके अंदर मैं 2 minus फीडिंग कर रहा था और इसमें 5, फिर ऐसे ऐसे मैं करते गया तो मैंने फिर बीच में आने का टाइम नहीं मिला, तो फिर 28 February से फिर मैंने इसको पूरा प्रोटोकॉल चेंज कर दिया, तो सब में मोइना फीडिंग करना था, तो जो ए सीरीज़ दिख रहा है उसमें 28 से कुछ मोइना फीडिंग नहीं किया था, और इसमें सिर्फ मोइना 30 minus फीडिंग करने थे। तो फिर इसमें मैं कंट्रोल रख रहा हूँ, तो कंट्रोल में इसमें कुछ हम लोग को देना नहीं, इको सिस्टम बनाना है तो हम लोग को कुछ उसको देना ना पड़ेगा, तो इसलिए कंट्रोल में कुछ मोइना फीडिंग नहीं, और इसमें 30 minus डेली A1 A2 A3 में हेल्थ। तो ये करने के बाद फिर रिजल्ट ये आया, अगर हम लोग किसी की बहुत सारे लैब में रहते हैं एग्जाम चालू हो जाता है, इसलिए इको सिस्टम भी तो इंपॉर्टेंट ये बनाने का था, इसमें क्या हाइड्रा सर्वाइव होंगे जिसमें मोइना फीड करें वो इंक्रीज़ होगी, और जिसमें हम लोग एल्गे के साथ फीडिंग आगे कर भी रहे मतलब स्टार्टिंग में किया 10-15 दिन बाद अगर भूल गए तो उसके लिए ये जो VCDs का वेल्स है ये उसके लिए। तो इसमें क्या इसमें हम लोग कुछ मोइना फीडिंग मैंने 28 से मैंने कुछ मोइना फीडिंग नहीं किया 6 तक, तो इसमें भी हाइड्रा तो इसमें भी इसमें 3 हाइड्रस और इसमें भी 3 हाइड्रस, उतने सब नंबर्स बराबर थे हाइड्रा के, तो 17 January के स्टार्ट करने के बाद भी। तो इसमें ए वेल्स में हाइड्रा इंक्रीज मतलब फास्ट हो रहे थे, तो 10 days में रिजल्ट ये आया था, इसमें अराउंड 25 हाइड्रा थे टोटल का एवरेज 25 हाइड्रा थे, और इसमें ए सीरीज में टोटल एवरेज 10 हाइड्रा थे। तो इसका मीन्स यहाँ पे इस 10 days में 8 to 6 days में तो 10 days हो गए, तो उसमें क्या हो रहा है इसमें हाइड्रा इंक्रीज़ हो रहा है, मतलब कुछ फीडिंग हम लोग उसको कर भी नहीं है तभी वो इंक्रीज़ हो रहा है सर्वाइव हो रहा है वो, और इसमें हम लोग फीड करें तो उसमें हम लोग ज़्यादा नंबर्स मिल रहे हैं। एक कॉलेज में एग्ज़ाम होता है, एग्ज़ाम में कोई का रिसर्च करे किसको काम कहीं घूमने जाना ऐसा कोई लॉन्ग घूमने का, तो वहाँ पे अगर हम लोग हाइड्रा का सेटअप इसमें अगर छोड़ भी दें तो हाइड्रा सर्वाइव करेगा पर इंक्रीज़ नहीं होगा। तो इसमें मेन पॉइंट्स ये, अगर किसको भी अगर हाइड्रा कल्चर करना है तो मोइना फीडिंग करते ऑल्टरनेट डेज भी करेंगे तो भी चलेगा, हाइड्रा सर्वाइव अगर हम लोग हाइड्रा को एक्सपेरिमेंट करें, अगर हाइड्रा हमारे पास है तो हम लोग एक्सपेरिमेंट कर सकते, हाइड्रा है तो वो हाइड्रा इसमें से हम लोग फिर निकाल के इसे ये मैंने बताया हाउ टू कल्चर हाइड्रा, तो हाइड्रा कल्चर के लिए मोइना बोटल्स, तो उसमें मोइना बोटल्स ऑलरेडी हम लोग पास है, तो ये हाइड्रा निकाल के हम लोग को दूसरे कप्स में लेना पड़ेगा। जैसे कि ये कप्स है, तो इसमें हम लोग जो हाइड्रा हम लोग वेल्स में जो बचे हुए हाइड्रा उसमें लेके हम लोग डाल के कल्चर हुआ हाइड्रा कर सकते हैं। कल्चर करने में हम लोग जो एक्सपेरिमेंट करना है जैसे कि रीजनरेशन, तो हाइड्रा में भी कैपेसिटी है रीजनरेशन करने की, तो उसके ऊपर यहाँ भी बताएंगे। तो ऑब्जेक्टिव था तो क्रिएट सस्टेनेबल इकोसिस्टम हाइड्रा इन सिक्स वेल प्लेट्स। तो यहाँ पे मैंने बेल प्लेट्स यूज़ किए, सिक्स वेल प्लेट्स है इसमें सबका वॉल्यूम, इसमें 10 ml एल्गे वाटर डाला था, तो यहाँ पे लिखा है एल्गे वाटर प्लस मोइना। तो उससे तो फिर मैं एक इसके कैलकुलेशन में निकला कि अगर हम लोग हाइड्रा कल्चर कर रहे हैं, अगर हम लोग हाइड्रा को डेली फीडिंग नहीं करेंगे तो भी वो सर्वाइव होगा, एल्गे में कर रहे वैसा भी हम लोग अगर छोड़ दिया हाइड्रा को 9 to 10 डेज ही फीडिंग नहीं किए तो भी हाइड्रा सर्वाइव होगा। प्लेन वाटर डिस वाटर में डाले तो 9 डेज तक हाइड्रा सर्वाइव होगा। मतलब अभी बहुत सारे लोग ज़्यादातर ध्यान नहीं देते, तो एक यहाँ पे किसी ने हाइड्रा कॉलेज में कल्चर, तो बोले कि 3 दिन में हम लोग हाइड्रा मर जाते हैं उसको, 3 डेज में फूड अगर नहीं फीड किया तो यहाँ पे वो उसी मतलब इतने सारे प्रॉब्लम्स हो रहेगा, किसको भी आगे एक्सपेरिमेंट करना है तो वो नहीं कर सकता वो। तो इसलिए इकोसिस्टम मैंने जो सिंपल, अगर हम लोग को आगे कुछ अगर एक्सपेरिमेंट हाइड्रा पे करना है तो मेरा ये।
We had started Moina culture in lab first. So these are the cups of Moina, cup culture of Moina. Yeah. For culturing Moina, we had taken 500 ml of plastic cups. In that, we had added 25 ml of DC water. Each of us had made 2 cups, and in both the cups, we had added 5-5 Moina. One cup was, in one cup, we had added 1 drop of milk, and the other cup, we had added 2 drops of milk, and now we have large number of Moina. And for culturing Hydra, we had taken a small cup, in that we had added 50 ml of DC water, and we had 6 cup cultures of Hydra, and in each of these 6 cup cultures we had added 1-1 Hydra. So we had started Hydra culture with 6 Hydras, and now today we have 270 Hydras in total. So now Harshada will explain about amputation of Hydra.
I'm going to explain about amputation of a hydra. First, we are trying to study on regeneration of a hydra. For हमने सबने देखा है कि books में और हम लोग के studies में 10th से 12th तक हमने पढ़ा है कि hydra regeneration होता है, but वो किसी ने किया है क्या? वो हमने भी नहीं किया था, इसीलिए हम लोग ने वो regeneration का study करना start किया. उसके लिए वी हैव टू एम्प्यूटेड सम हाइड्रास. फॉर दैट वी एम्प्यूटेड 6 हाइड्रास ऑन 30th December. हाइड्रा वेयर कैप्टन 2 हाइड्रास आर कैप्टन फॉर अ कंट्रोल, एंड देन वी एम्प्यूटेड 6 हाइड्रास इन डिफरेंट मैनर एंड डिफरेंट वेज विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ शार्प नीडल और अ शार्प नीडल. These are the two hydra controls which kept for a two hydras which kept for a control. First setup was we did. First was we taken we take took 2 hydras. We amputated these hydras in 2 parts, which is first is a head part and second is a remaining body part, which is base part. Then observation after 44 hours, we found that this is the head part of a hydra which regenerate basal part and attaches on the surface of the glass, and this is the base part which basal part it has regenerated small tentacles, and after 44 hours. Second setup we did was first is we amputated 1 hydra in a 3 parts. First is a head part, second is a middle part, and third is a base part. And we observed after 44 hours that this is the first part, head part of a hydra, which regenerate. Next thing. This is the basal part part of a hydra, which regenerated small tentacles are observed. And the remaining two parts, which are head part is regenerated in the basal part, and base part is regenerated in the head part, and middle part is regenerated in some small tentacles with the base part. This is the third setup, our third setup. We are amputated one hydra in three parts, which is a head part with tentacles, a head part, tentacles, and the remaining part of a hydra. Then observation after 44 hours was that head part is regenerate, head part is regenerate in remaining part of a hydra, and base part is regenerate in tentacles and head part of a hydra. Setup, we made setup at home because hum log ka abhi college time hai, exams time hai, hum log ko time nahi milta idhar aane ke liye. तो हम लोग ने किचन हम लोग अभी बोल रहे हैं कि किचन लैब किया, वो किचन लैब हमने घर पे किया है, और वो दीप्ति, हर्षद, मी एंड अश्विनी, हम तीनों ने वो घर पे किया. दीप्ति ने किया इकोसिस्टम ऑफ हाइड्रा प्लस अलगे एंड मोइना. अश्विनी हाइड्रा सेटअप फीडिंग मोइना एंड टू ऑब्जर्व टिल हाउ मेनी डेज कैन हाइड्रा सर्वाइव विदाउट फूड. एंड I did the hydra setup feeding Moina and the rotifers. Further part is explaining by Deepti, by Ashwini.
Okay. For culturing hydra at home, requirements are ice tray, DC water, Moina is source of food, algae for ecosystem, and we had started the system setup on 17th of Jan. So my setup. I had made two setups for one hydra culture and one Moina culture. This is my hydra culture, and this is the Moina culture. So for Moina culture, I had 500 ml of plastic cups, in which I had added 250 ml of DC water, and I had made three cups and duplicates of these three cups. First cup I had added one drop of milk, and second cup two drops of milk, and in third cup three drops of milk. So we had taken six hydras home. On 17th I had nine hydras. So five in that ice tray, in each well I had added 5 ml of DC water and one hydra in each well. So total nine wells. Five hydras were feeded with Moina and four hydras were not feeded since 17th. I had to observe that can hydra survive without food and for how many days. So the hydras which were feeded with Moina, now I have 75 hydras from that five hydras, and the hydras which were not feeded since 17th of January, they died on 5th February. So hydra can survive without food till 20 days. So this was my observation.
I'm going to set explaining setup of my culture, hydra culture. For that I made one Moina culture and one rotifer culture for feeding hydra. I made Moina culture with a 250 ml of a DC water, in that adding 5 Moinas and feeding four two drops of a in 250 ml culture we can add two drops of a milk, and in 500 ml culture we can add four drops of a milk. In ice tray I added six hydras. Three hydras were fed Moina and were fed Moina with Moina, and the other hydras were fed with a rotifers. But Moina culture is good, but hydra died because hydra was died after 4 or 5 days because of some conditions was not able to hydra. Hydras which were fed rotifers died as a rotifer would eat hydra. जो हमने observe किया था वो ये किया था कि microscope के अंदर हमने हम hydra rotifer hydra culture में rotifer डाला, तो हम लोग ने थोड़े थोड़े time बाद ये observe किया कि because of this rotifers हाइड्रा डैमेज हो रहा है, तो हमने वो स्टडी करना स्टार्ट किया कि वो क्यों मतलब रोटीफर का इफेक्ट हाइड्रा पे क्यों हो रहा है, और मोइना इज इंक्रीजिंग इन नंबर टिल टुडे.
This was the my setup. Basically, I was doing the ecosystem for the Hydra. In that, I take a ice cube. In that, I had used 6 whales. In each whale, I had added 1 Hydra, 1 ml of algae, and 7 ml of DC water. And in each whale, I had added 5 Moina each. And today I am having a total of 14 Hydra, which were there, but as number of Moina decreased, so I couldn't feed them later on. So this was our setup. And our goof up was, we didn't made fresh cup culture of Moina. We didn't click photos of the amputation setup of Hydra, and daily observation were not written regularly. Thank you.
I just wanted to make few points. I forgot. Good morning, I'm Sheetal Shetty from SIES College, and I'll be talking about how to maintain the cultures in different situations that we face when we do kitchen lab. Just like they face problems, I too face problems when I took Hydra from Cube Lab to my college to culture them. And basically, these are my Hydras that were there after 4 to 5 days under the microscope. So my immediate objective right now is to maintain a healthy culture of Hydra using simple reproducible methods that can be done at home without any problem with simple tools. And the short-term objective is to study a population growth curve right now with different situations that I'll be talking about later. It goes with their studies because they're studying that what effect does starvation have on Hydra and how many days it can survive. So I'll be studying that same pattern with this. And the long-term objective is to compare these curves and find out what is the reason that it happens like that. So maintaining a model system is not an easy job because it requires a lot of work. And bottlenecks or difficulties are part of it. And creating an artificial ecosystem for an organism inside your house or at your place comes with its own challenges. So the problem number one that y'all will face, or anyone will face, is where to keep the organism. Because if you take an organism or a setup at home, the first thing that comes is space. Keeping a tank or something at your home is not easy. You need to find that space at home. So, and if that organism increases in number, you cannot keep them in a cup culture for long times. You need to change their setups. So the thing that I did at my house or at my lab in college was that I had taken 3 Hydras from Cube Lab to my college, and I'd keeping them in a small cup, plastic cup of 50 ml capacity. And when the number increased, I transferred them into a 250 ml beaker so that they get more space to increase. And later on, if it increases more, now at the right moment, I have 70 Hydras with me in a period of, I think, 1 month almost. And if it increases more in number, I'll be making more cup culture, beaker cultures actually. I'll put in different number of, or divide them into more beakers. And later on, we can have a tank of Hydra, but that still needs to be worked upon. So this is the Hydra culture when I had taken it from Cube Lab. And this is a 250 ml beaker where you can keep your Hydras later on. The second problem is about feed, as Harshad or someone faced the problem of not having too much Moina to feed their Hydra. So if such a problem arises, what is the solution to that? So first of all, when you take Moina, or when you have a limited source of Moina, what you can do is, when there is lesser number of Hydra, feed them daily, just so that you can increase their number. But once they increase, the thing that I went on to do was, I fed them every alternate day, just so that they get, Moina gets time to reproduce, and so that the number increases. So now I have a very good culture of Moina with three beakers, and they are reproducing really well. And I feed my Hydra every alternate day with Moina, and my Hydra are also growing well. So this can be a solution to your problem. And these are two photos of Hydra catching the Moina, and this is Hydra engulfing the Moina that we observed under the microscope. Now, these are the goof-ups that I have done. The first thing, and my PPT comes out from these goof-ups. These solutions are only after I did the goof-ups. So the first one was, I transferred my Hydra into a tank. I decided to do that, but the only thing is, I didn't duplicate it. That is, I didn't I transferred all of my Hydra together into a tank without keeping just some to test if they die or is there any effect of it. So that was the thing, but I was lucky it didn't die. Feeding these Hydras, I had 70, so I feed 75 Moinas to them, and I didn't realize that feeding a large number would also cause me problems of decrease in number of Moina. That's why that changed into giving them alternate days feed. I didn't click pictures or take photos or videos of me maintaining these Hydras and how do I clean it or how do I feed it. I've never taken those photos and videos. I do have some. And used a tank to keep a Hydra without realizing that it may cause me a problem with space in the lab, because there's not one thing in the lab, there are many things. And I maintained my Moina in three beakers instead of transferring them into a tank. That would have been much more better for me. So my future plans, as I told in the starting, is to study the growth curve or the population pattern under different conditions. And I'll be studying three cases in that. The first case is Hydra, I'll keep equal number of Hydras in three different beakers. And in one beaker, I'll be feeding them with Moina daily. And the second one will be, I'll be feeding them once in a week. And in the third case, I'll be starving them to see, and this will happen for a period of 2 weeks, to see what difference in their population occurs if in these different cases of feeding or starvation. My expectation is that in the case one, the number of Hydra will increase frequently or in a very good number at a good pace. My case two will be, the number will increase, but it will be at a slower rate, or it will take a lot of days to increase. The case three will be, the number will increase initially because of the food it has eaten earlier, or because of maybe a reservoir of energy in it. But later on, it may become static, because as we call Hydra immortal, there can be a state where they don't reproduce, or it can start decreasing also. So it's still under study. Any questions for that? You can ask all of us together.
Okay, hello, hello. Hello, can you hear me? I just want to take off, give some takeoff points from this project. I'm very excited to see how so many people are working on it, and then there is some success. I'm sure Professor Surendra would also be excited to see the Hydra is spreading, not only in colleges, but also in kitchen. Now, what has happened? Very strong points in cube. Ek to goof up hai. And recently when we were going to cube Konkan during our field trip, we were just listening to a song which the driver was playing, and suddenly wo song aa gaya, teri umar hai kar le galti se mistake. So we thought, arey, this is the best appropriation of this song for, you know, goof ups. So goof ups and serendipity se hi scientific discovery hoti hai. So why not, you know, we make this sort of, you know, song for cube goof ups. So keep making mistakes. And the other thing is jugad. Whatever we are doing is, you know, we are sort of saying ki we have to come up with several jugaads, you know, very easy to do things that are available in our lab or home. So one interesting jugaad was the ice tray. I mean, we were really surprised, and we were excited to see that, you know, the expensive well plates were substituted with the easily available ice trays. Fir abhi just I was talking to Mayur, then I was thinking from one of the slides, wo jo color watercolor ke box aata hai, right, camlin acrylic ke color box aate hai, to wo bhi ho sakte hai. So you know, one thing can lead to several such ideas. So think about it and let your imagination get, you know, carry on with several types of jugaad or whatever you are thinking to work for the project. So you know, the availability or non availability of the tissue culture plate or well plate is not stopping the project. It is going on, and I think it was a good work, so good show, and I am excited because you know, we started Hydra and Mayur was working with us, and not to mention that Mayur mentored these people, and of course Arif, who is a 9th standard student, he's been mentoring the undergraduate students. So you can see here, you know, so all these are, you know, cube ke culture that are being highlighted, and they are being shown that it's working, and of course it will work. So that is the excitement that I wanted to share. Anything else if I'm missing? Yeah, and you can go on vacation for maximum 20 days if you are Hydra. Okay, so that's also a takeoff point.
Yeah, anybody has any questions? So we can quickly have the thing, because yeah, questions please.
मेरा क्वेश्चन आरिफ से है. सो आरिफ, जो आपने शुरू में दो सेटअप्स लगाए, सो यू सॉ फॉर स्टार्टिंग विद वन हाइड्रा, एक में दो हाइड्रा और तीन हाइड्रा, तो अलॉन्ग विद दैट अगर सिर्फ वाटर में हाइड्रा का कंट्रोल, डिड यू चेक दैट सिर्फ वाटर में हाइड्रा का कंट्रोल बिना किसी एल्गे या मोइना के, अलॉन्ग विद दैट? सो यू डिडंट शो दैट?
मैंने नहीं किया क्योंकि उसमें कन्फर्म नहीं है भैया. तो मैंने इससे पहले भी और एक्सपेरिमेंट्स किया था उसके स्टार्टिंग में, तो एक तुम यहाँ पे डेली में से 10,000 मोइना डेली लैब में मांगा था, उतना मैं मोइना 10,000 डेली का मोइना मैं कैसे दूंगा और क्यों चाहिए लैब को? हाँ, तो लैब से मतलब मोइना 10,000 डेली का मोइना मांगा, तो मैंने पूछा कि मोइना क्यों चाहिए, तो उन्होंने बताया कि मतलब हाइड्रा है उसको सॉल्ट वाटर में फीड करे, तो मैं हाँ मैं दे सकता हूँ, पर एक हाइड्रा कितना मोइना खाता है? मैंने उसी से फिर मैंने कंट्रोल रखा था जिसमें कि कुछ हाइड्रा कुछ फीडिंग नहीं है प्लेन वाटर में, अराउंड 90 डेज तक वो अलाइव था. प्लेन वाटर में हम लोग हाइड्रा अलाइव रहते, पर वो मल्टीप्लाई नहीं होगा. अब फूड उसको हम लोग देंगे तो ही मल्टीप्लाई होगा.
एंड ऑल्सो व्हाट इज़ द डिफरेंस अगर मैं हाइड्रा को एल्गे के साथ रख रहा हूँ और हाइड्रा को सिर्फ पानी में रख रहा हूँ, इज देयर एनी डिफरेंस?
हाँ, तो हाइड्रा को प्लेन वाटर में हम लोग रख रहे हैं तो उसमें कुछ दूसरा ऑर्गेनिजम्स भी रहेगा, मतलब बैक्टीरिया का, मतलब उसमें एल्गे प्रोवाइड, तो एल्गे क्या एनर्जी सन से ले रहा है तो वो एनर्जी दूसरों को देता है, जो उसके अंदर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स रहेंगे एल्गे डीके मतलब मरेगा तो बैक्टीरिया पैदा होगा, तो वो बैक्टीरिया से तो हम लोग ने ऑब्जर्व किया था कि जो ये वेल प्लेट्स का, तो उसमें जैसे कि VCDs का, तो उसमें क्या था कि उसमें कुछ था नहीं, तो उसमें कुछ कौन सा माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म था, उसमें हम लोग को एलोजोमा दिखा था, एलोजोमा और दूसरे टाइप्स का रोटीफर, जैसा हम लोग नॉर्मली रोटीफर दिखा था, और उसमें एल्गे था, तो एल्गे के अंदर कुछ था डोनेट टाइप का कुछ शेप था, उसका नेम मालूम क्या है, वो भी उसके अंदर प्रेजेंट था, तो शायद वो खा के वो सर्वाइव हाइड्रा हो रहा, इसलिए सस्टेनेबल इकोसिस्टम हाइड्रा को क्रिएट हो रहा है वहाँ पे, तो अपने आप से हाइड्रा वहाँ पे सर्वाइव हो रहा है.
एंड टू ऑल द ग्रुप्स आई कैन सजेस्ट वन थिंग दैट अपार्ट फ्रॉम सीइंग दैट इट्स मल्टीप्लाइंग और नॉट, यू कैन ऑल्सो लुक एट द ग्रोथ, लाइक यू हैव नॉट रिपोर्टेड अबाउट द ग्रोथ पैटर्न्स, इज द ग्रोथ ऑफ द हाइड्रा सेम लाइक फ्रॉम द बर्ड टू वट एवर साइज इट एक्सटेंड्स टू, इज इट सेम इन वाटर प्लस वाटर हाइड्रा एंड एल्गे एंड हाइड्रा एल्गे एंड मोइना? Like you can also see that, because if it is about multiplication, there must be some change in the growth also, right?
Yeah.
Hydra ka khana agar moina hai, moina ka khana bacteria hai, to hum direct bacteria nahi de sakte kya hydra ko?
To direct bacteria hydra ko tum hydra ko hum direct bacteria, hum log bacteria hydra ko provide nahi, hum log moina hydra ko dal rahe, to hum bacteria hum log kyun dalenge? Milk, उसमें मिल्क रहेगा, मिल्क के प्रोटीन्स रहेंगे उसमें और भी बैक्टीरिया रहेंगे, तो अगर हम लोग एक वेल प्लेट्स अगर कुछ जैसे आइस क्यूब या कुछ ले रहे हैं उसमें अगर मोइना तो हम लोग मोइना हाइड्रा के ले रहा है, हम लोग को मिल्क मिल्क मोइना के लिए डाल रहे हैं तो हम लोग मिल्क इसलिए लगे उस ऐसे कि मैंने बताया कि पहले मैंने एक्सपेरिमेंट किया तो इसमें क्या हुआ था तो पहले मैं उसको वॉशिंग नहीं करता था, मैं सीधा मोइना निकाल के बोतल से डायरेक्ट में फीड कर देता था, उसकी वजह से हाइड्रा मर गया था। सर आपने बताया कि उसे साथ में करना चाहिए तो सेम वही बोतल में क्या मिल्क का कंटेन है मोइना है तो मैंने सीधा बोतल से ड्रॉपर से निकाला मोइना और सीधा डेली फीडिंग करा तो उसमें वो नेक्स्ट डे या थर्ड डे पे देखा तो उसमें कोई हाइड्रा मेरे को दिखा नहीं। उसके
सी बैक्टीरिया तो रहता ही है बट देन हाइड्रा इज बिट यू नो हायर ऑर्डर ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड देन बडिंग के लिए इंक्रीजिंग करने के लिए इट नीड्स एनर्जी एंड देन वी नीड टू प्रोवाइड प्रोटीन सोर्स टू इट एंड प्रोटीन कहाँ से मिलेगा ये टाइनी क्रस्टेशन से मिलेगा सो दैट्स वाई वी हैव टू यू नो फीड टाइनी क्रस्टेशंस मोइना या अल्टीमिया जो भी है।
You know, we eat food from plants, and plants make food from inorganic things. So the question is that why can't we directly take sunlight? You know, is a million-dollar question. I mean, I think I appreciate the question. Absolutely.
Questions, please. Yeah. So I have a question, like you said you are maintaining Moinas at home, right? And also with one drop, two drop, and one drop, two drop, three drop. So why are you maintaining in them with another different drops? Why are you having Moina culture setups with different drops, like one drop in two drops and three drops? Is there a specific reason or just randomly?
एक्चुअली ये थ्री ड्रॉप्स टू ड्रॉप्स इसलिए किया क्योंकि हमें देखना था कि कोई कौन से ड्रॉप में सबसे ज़्यादा मोइना इंक्रीज़ हो रहा है तो टू ड्रॉप्स और थ्री ड्रॉप्स में ज़्यादा हो रहा था, वन ड्रॉप में इतना नहीं हो रहा था सो इसीलिए हमने वन ड्रॉप टू ड्रॉप थ्री ड्रॉप्स का सेटअप बनाया।
एंड आर यू चेकिंग द कलर ऑफ द मोइना व्हाइल एडिंग फीडिंग देम?
यस।
सो व्हाट कलर इज इट व्हेन यू फीड देम?
आफ्टर सिक्स डेज वी गेट रेड मोइना।
सो आर यू फीडिंग रेड मोइनास टू द हाइड्रा और
वी आर?
Yeah, so is there any change, means if colorless are given or red are given, is there any change in their growth or reproduction?
No, there is no specific change.
Okay. And what is your main research question in this Hydra project? Why are you doing culturing of Hydra?
Okay, so first, when we just heard that Hydra is also a model organism, we just... Okay, yeah. So we just wanted to see that we had studied in 9th standard that Hydra can regenerate, but we had not seen it. So our first objective was to see that Hydra can regenerate. So we did that and we saw that Hydra is really regenerating. And the second objective is to create an ecosystem so that we can, means if we are having, so if we are busy or we are not able to feed Hydra, so that.
Aren't there any research articles suggesting that already the Hydra regenerates or not? Have you found any? Thank you.
Okay, so yeah, we are actually struggling for the time. So yeah, we thank you very much for the very very wonderful session. Yeah. So now we shall be breaking for the tea. So I think you know, I think 10 minutes may we should be able to return and continue the session because yeah, we will be breaking for the tea. Yeah, because they are